So 2020 kind of sucked, and I know many of us really are looking at the news and are looking at the numbers. Many of us are living in different countries that are currently going through their second wave or on their second lockdown. South Africa has just been put back on level 3 lockdown, and it's hard to really find the good. But I'm going to read you a quote that my dance teacher actually sent to us. This year has been far from perfect, but I still see the good. I see how much friendships matter. I see the gift in the moment. I see connections. I see how we can adapt. I see how strong we are. I see the good despite the challenges. I see a powerful year for the next generation to learn about. I see us and how we didn't quit, how we kept on rising up. Sometimes the most powerful lessons are discovered in the most challenging times. A quote by Rachel Marie Martin. And I think that this year, although yes, so many people have lost their lives and the world has been basically put on hold and has really made us think about things and sacrifice things, it has given so many of us lessons. And I asked many of you guys on Instagram to send through a small message to me, which I can use. And so I'm just going to read out some of that. Also, if you do hear the fan on, I'm really sorry. It's like 32 degrees in Johannesburg today. And I also don't usually wear buns in my hair because they damage your hair. But it's just so hot. I like actually cannot deal with it. So I have a fan on and I'm really sorry about that. So I'm just going to read small snippets kind of out of what everyone sent me, and I'm going to put it here on the screen. Please feel free to kind of pause the video, read through it, or see if you resonate with it. But I'm going to take out the most heart-wrenching or the most gut-punching kind of things that people are grateful for. So the first one is from someone that would like to be kept anonymous, and she said that some things have to be learned the hard way, but it was definitely all worth it in the end. And I think that's an epitome of what 2020 is about. Like, you look at it and you think, okay, yes, there was the BLN movement, there was a whole focus on the femicide, there was a whole thing about how mental health is struggling during these times, how people are dying, how people are trying to save lives on the front. But the fact that we have learned so much from all of these difficult things that have happened, it makes us worth it in the end, because I think this year is really pivotal in everyone's lives and learning more about themselves and just how to appreciate things, and that we are definitely stronger than we think. My cousin then sent me that she is so grateful to have been able to spend the first year with her son, so my nephew, who's the cutest baby on this planet. But basically, as you guys know, you have maternity leave for like 2 months and then you're going back, and you can miss out on milestones, you can miss out on your child's first steps, the first crawling or the first words or the first time they might be able to eat food. You really do miss out those moments if you are working, and it is a sad reality. But she got to spend time with her son this entire first year, and I'm so happy. She's also pregnant again, and she's going to be able to give a little sister to him. And that's another thing that she was grateful for, and I think it's something that a lot of people have been doing this year, is a lot of people have gotten pregnant. And I think that is really the light at the end of the tunnel, or a ray of hope that has come out of this year. A lot of my friends as well, you know, they all said that they are so grateful for our friendship group, because really I don't think we would have been able to get through this really difficult academic year without one another, without helping each other, without asking each other for advice, or even just giving each other the support that they needed to get through that test or that hard assignment. And you know, sometimes communication can get lost through online school, and us being there for each other, not only actually in academics, but just being there as a supportive pillar when we were going through something, or just offering that piece of advice, I think makes us really grateful. I mean, I've spoken to them on a daily basis, and it's seriously something that became a part of my routine in the day, something that honestly just made me feel so much more grateful to just be alive and have them in my life, to know that I can count on them for anything.
The thing I am grateful for the most, and that this year has made me realize I need to actually be grateful for, is being alive and being able to live.
Now, a common theme in like all of the entries that I did get is that this year has made people grow and learn so much about themselves, things that they had no idea with. And my friend Shudu, who I actually went to high school with, she said that she has experienced the most personal growth that she has in her entire life, and that's the biggest thing that she was grateful for. And I'm sure it's the same for many of you watching this video as well. A lot of people also said that they are so grateful for the time that they got to spend with their family compared to, like, you know, the hectic schedules everyone's always have. Everyone's always on the go with their job, trying to get good academics, trying to get the most sales, or trying to be the most competitive that they can be. But they always tend to forget about the people that they are always surrounded with, which is usually their family or just their roommates. My aunt even said that she's so grateful, like, you know, for her child, and that our intermediate family thankfully was extremely lucky to not get the virus per se, but obviously other things have happened this year. And I agree with her that last year truly was one of the worst years I think that could have happened for my family. I mean, my aunt who sent this, she had a brain aneurysm last year, and my grand passed away, which I have spoken about. And so this year compared to last year is, personally for me and my family, it's not as bad. And so she's grateful that, you know, she's alive and she's healthy compared to last year. Another thing that one of my friends said, which is actually something I wouldn't personally have thought of, but it's so true. She is grateful for many things, like her family and her academics, but she said she's thankful for social media this year becoming such a strong community where people were kind of sharing their struggles, saying, you know what, you're not alone. Whether it was, again, the BLM movement, the femicide movement, or even just with healthcare and the systems that are different across the world, everyone was edging together to kind of donate to charities or to help the homeless and share their struggles, even with mental health issues that have happened, or giving tips about how online school can be helped with, or things like that. And she said that's what she's grateful for, and that's an amazing thing to be grateful for, because, you know, it's so easy to have someone to talk to, like your family, and say, you know, this is how I'm feeling. But when a stranger says that they're feeling the exact same way as you, it gives you some kind of comfort that many strive for, because you know you definitely are not in it alone, and that your family isn't just saying something to make you feel better. This next one is extremely true, and it's that this year taught me that putting yourself first is not selfish, it's necessary. This is such a beautiful, strong quote, which I 100% agree with, because for me personally, what I've learned this year is so much about myself. I've realized that there are more skills than I thought that I had. There's more things that I learned about how I deal with situations, how I deal with my family, how best I deal with the emotions that I have, how I kind of get back up from whatever has happened. And a lot of people have felt that way. They've discovered a new skill, a new hobby, a new way of life in general. People have been able to start something that they've always wanted to do. They've realized that their self-worth and their time is more necessary than spending it on someone that really is not good for your mental health, that is selfish, that doesn't do anything conducive for your life. And this, I think, everyone can say they agree with, because this has to be something that this year has taught you about yourself. So my friend Limpopo, she and I went to high school together, and now we're in university together. She said she's thankful for getting her license, me and you too, girl. And she said that she's so happy that she passed second year, me too, girl. And then she said that she's also met the girl of her dreams, and she hopes to spend the rest of her life with. And I am so happy that not only her, I've heard a lot of people, even one of my other friends from university, they've found someone that really makes them feel good and loved. And in these uncertain times, that's what a lot of people needed. And I'm so happy that she and maybe others that are watching this have found someone that they really just have clicked with, and that they can see spending their future with. And the last category that people really did speak about is that they have realized how short life is, and that the smaller things in life truly do matter, such as walking on a beach or going on a walk with your dog. Life really is short. We have lost millions of people this year, and it has taught many people that if not now, when? And if not me, then who? And this is a very famous quote by Sri Satya Sai Baba. And this is so true. And I can give a personal example for this. I've always wanted to start a YouTube channel. I've always wanted to start an eco-friendly business. And I've done both of those things this year because I had so much of time on my hand. And I realized that, why do I have to be, for instance, sitting in front of the TV for 20 hours? Why do I have to only be concentrated on getting good marks? Why do I only have to be concentrated on keeping my health and fitness right? That there is actually so many hours in a day that if you feel like doing something, just go for it. The worst that can happen is that it doesn't work out and then you eventually find something that's better. But even just with treating people with kindness, just, you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. You don't know how that person is going to be tomorrow. You don't know if that person's going to be alive tomorrow. No one knows what the future holds. And so taking each day, day by day, one step at a time, and living that day to the fullest, doing the most that you can with that day and doing whatever fulfills you in that day, even if it's something small like going and eating that chocolate biscuit or gardening or taking your dog for a walk or watching a movie with your family after such a long time, those small things, or even big things if you're wanting to do something big, truly make life worth living. And I think this year has taught us just to slow down and reprioritize everything in our life and show also about us that our life is short. So why do you have to worry about what other people say? Live it for yourself and just be kind to people because you never know what can happen. And the last thing is something that I want to add in, obviously because I am an ecology student, so this thing that I'm going to talk about is extremely essential to what has happened this year. And that is that the environment has become such a focal point for people, and it has healed a bit due to people having to stop production and things like that. And although it sounds so bad and people have lost their jobs about it, it's really made us think about how we affect the earth. You know, when production was shut down and people weren't, you know, having recreational activities, people weren't fishing, people weren't playing cricket or whatever, everyone started to see how the fish were replenishing in the Venice lakes or the Venice canals. It just showed us like how easy it is to kind of just decrease your production, try and be cleaner, make more adjustments to your life. And it also just showed us how much time we actually have left to try and make a change to this earth and its living being. And if we don't make a change now, this definitely will not be the last pandemic. So yes, I strayed off a bit, but honestly, this year has for many people changed their priority list and has changed their perspective about life, about themselves, and it's taught them about actually who are the people that are genuinely wanting to help others and who are selfish. Who are those that truly still think this virus is a hoax, or who think that going out and partying and having a drink or going out with like 50 friends without any masks or not social distancing, how those people seriously are not worth your time. Because if the entire world is in a deadly pandemic and people really cannot put their own small things aside, like having a drink and going to a club, those people really just aren't conducive to your life, because obviously they are just extremely selfish. That's another thing that I think I've personally learned this year. I have learned who are the people that will help me, who are the people that will help what's for the greater good and not be selfish and only worry about their own things. So that's another big lesson I'm sure many of us has learned. So in conclusion, although this year has been so hard for many, I think it has been one of the most important years in anyone's life. In my 20 years of being, I feel that this year probably will be a year that will be probably in my top three for my entire life. That has been the most important and pivotal years in my life, because it's just taught me so much that I think I will just carry this learnings throughout my life. I don't think it will end as soon as this new year 2021 comes out. Oh, whatever lessons I learned in 2020, I'm just leaving. I think it's become an integral part of who I am, and I'm sure many of you would agree. It's really opened my eyes to many things that I didn't realize before, that I didn't take heed to or I didn't pay attention to as much as I should have. I'm sending you all tons of love, happiness, light, and positivity for 2021. Please stay kind, please stay strong, please stay healthy, and stay safe. Bye.